back to my channel. Continue watching this video so that way you can see how I accomplished this look and my hair as well. There's gonna be details about my hair and my lashes. Hey babes, and welcome to my channel, and happy Valentine's Day. Today we are going to be getting ready for my date. He told me to be ready by 8:30. It's around like 4 o'clock right now, and I'm not sure where we're going. I'm not sure what we're doing. He just told me to dress classy, so I'm guessing it's some food and who knows what else. So I'm excited. This is gonna be great. So stay tuned and you'll see how I accomplished my look for tonight. Oh yeah, and these beautiful roses over here, he gave them to me on Wednesday and asked me to be his Valentine. We usually don't hang out on Wednesday, so I thought it was like super weird that he asked me to hang out that day. And he brought these and some chocolate covered strawberries, and they tasted good because I'm not really a fan of chocolate and strawberries together. But yeah, I devoured those like instantly. They smell amazing. So right now, I do not have anything on my face. Wait, I'm lying. So I do have moisturizer on my face, and I did put some under eye serum, and I have some chapstick as well. And now I'm gonna put on some primer. So I'm gonna be wearing the Studio Perfect Photo Loving Primer from NYX. So I currently don't have anything on my eyebrows. I usually just brush them first. Oh my god, I need to get them waxed. It's been so long. I don't know if you guys can tell, but it's growing in. So I am using NYX's eyebrow pencil. I usually just fill in the gaps in my eyebrows. I don't like making them too dark because they're already pretty full. Anyways, so I'm gonna be using my Pro Concealer for my eyebrows and this angled brush. So now I have my Glam Glow Glow Starter. It is in Nude Glow. This does wonders to your foundation, guys. Like, I highly recommend it. I usually get Ipsy packages every month. I do the $25 pack because it's the full sizes. I haven't been to a beauty supply store in a while because they always send me products that I need. So I'm not sure if you guys can tell, but this is without foundation and my skin looks like it's already glowing. Sometimes when I go to work, I just put moisturizer on my face, eye serum on the bottom to like prevent puffiness, and this glow starter, and I'm out the door. Oh yeah, and some lip gloss. I'm always wearing lip gloss. So while that's settling into my face, I'm gonna start with my eyeshadow. So my dress is blue and I was gonna use Morphe James Charles palette. It has like all the colors you can think of. Voila, look at that. So before I put on my eyeshadow, I'm gonna set my concealer that I used for my eyebrows. And I'm gonna use this color right here. All right, so I'm gonna be using this color right here. So I decided to add some tape to help with my eyeshadow. It makes a huge difference, especially if you're gonna wing your eyeliner. I'm using this Wet n Wild corrector and concealer to do my cut crease. I am not the greatest. I'm still learning how to do this, so bear with me. I'm kind of messed up already, but makeup is fixable. That was pretty fixable right there, you see? So after I put my concealer on my eyelids for my cut crease, I'm going to put my ColourPop No Filter Setting Powder. I just use a simple brush like this. It looks so pretty. I'm gonna put this gold shimmer on my eyelid. After I put on my brush, I usually spray it. Your girl's looking a little crazy right now, but it's coming together. Just wait till the final end. I'm gonna go back to this color just to darken the one I put on first. I'm gonna go ahead and take this color to put on the corner of my eye. Go ahead and put on some eyeliner, and I really suck at putting on eyeliner. It's the longest like part of my routine, so bear with me again and we'll see how this goes. It's also very hard for me to put on top eyeliner because I have such short and curly eyelashes and they get in the way every time. Okay, so I am done with my eyeshadow and my eyebrows. So now I'm going to apply my lashes. I have these ones from my friend Nani. The packaging is honestly the cutest. I actually used these for my pageant and I got like so many compliments and I've been in love with them ever since. She has an Instagram page and I'm gonna tag it down below. These ones are pretty wispy. I've used these ones before, but I like the fact that they come very like long in length, so that way you can cut it to where it fits your eyelashes. Okay, so I applied my eyelashes. What I'm gonna do now is put on my mascara. I usually put it on after I put my lashes to blend my natural lashes with the falsies. They're so pretty. Right now I'm gonna do my face makeup, and then after I'm done with my face makeup is when I complete my bottom eyeliner and my bottom mascara. So I ran out of my favorite foundation. I usually use MAC Studio Fix NW44. So I have my backup, which is Fit Me. It is 355 Coconut. Damped my beauty blender. I prefer to use a beauty blender compared to a brush because it makes it look more airbrushed. I'm gonna use the same one that I used on my eyebrows, and I'm just gonna mark the places where I'm gonna contour my face. I'm gonna use the same damp beauty blender to finish up my face. I don't even know what I'm saying, guys. Like, I've been working constantly, and I work in a psych hospital, so it's, you know, it's pretty crazy, obviously, but it's different every day. So it's been a while since I've been off and I'm trying to get my sanity. So here I am making this video for my sanity. Of course I do other things, guys, like I work out and all that other stuff, but you know what I mean. So now I'm gonna use this Chestnut Pro Concealer. It's a couple shades darker than the one I had originally. And I'm gonna use this to snatch my face, baby. Ugh, it just like leaked. That's gross. That's really gross. Was that supposed to happen? I don't know what was going on with this concealer, and it's new, I just got this. Finished with my foundation and my concealer, so now I'm gonna do my baking powder, and I'm gonna use the same one, ColourPop No Filter Setting Powder in the shade Banana. Now with my setting powder, I usually use a dry beauty blender. Done putting on my foundation and my concealer. Next I'm gonna do some bronzer. I'm gonna use this color right here. That's one thing I really love about this palette. It's very versatile. Like, you can use it for highlighter, you can use it as a bronzer, and then also for your eyeshadow. It's amazing. So I have really high cheekbones, and what I really love to do is use this darker color over here just for my cheeks. I already put some on over here, that's why it's a little darker than this side. So I'm gonna apply some on this side. Trust me guys, I have more palettes, but I'm gonna use this one again. But this color that I use for my bronzer, I also put it on my cheeks because I'm wearing this eyeshadow that's really popping, so I don't want too much color on my face. I just put this on the apples on my cheeks. I'm done with my face makeup. I'm gonna put my highlighter last, but before I do that, I spray my face. I have this Tarte Double Duty Beauty Finishing Spray, and it's marvelous, ladies, marvelous. So for my highlighter, I'm going to be using two shades. A lot of highlighter products, but mostly from MAC because I used to work there. But these two are my favorite because I combined them both and it's just, it gives me a different shimmer. I have this highlighter right here. It's called Cheeky Bronze. And I start with this one first. A smaller brush for my nose. I get this one Soft and Gentle and do the same thing. Everything's coming together. It's looking pretty, really pretty. For my bottom eyeliner, I'm just gonna use a Maybelline's Ebony Black. Back to my mascara, and I'm going to put on my bottom lashes. I lost so many hair and makeup products at my pageant, so I'm gonna use this backup NYX lip pencil. It'll do for now. It's just a nude. I can't tell you the color because it's really short. already tested the color I was gonna put on my lips, like right in the middle, but I'm gonna be using NYX Lingerie Liquid Lipstick. It's number 5 and it's called Beauty Mark. This is honestly the best nude ever. It goes with my complexion. It lasts all day. It doesn't smudge. It's good if you have a boyfriend. It doesn't smear. So yeah, I totally recommend. I'm gonna go ahead and spray my Tarte finishing spray. And I am finally done with my makeup. I haven't beat my face in so long because all I do is work. So you know, it feels good. And I know my man's gonna think it looks good too. And now I'm gonna go ahead and do my hair. I already did my hair earlier today. I did my edges as well, so I'm just gonna straighten it and I'm gonna change and we'll be done. I've had this hair for about like a month and a half. I got it from Rae Padgett and I got so many compliments. I got it from my good friend Jemaya. She sells hair and she does hair. We've been at it for like 8 years and she's the best. 22 inches. I actually got it Brazilian wave naturally and I just straightened it and washed it this morning and it doesn't even look like it had a curl to it. Jemaya lives in Bakersfield, California. That's where I was born and raised, but she also makes and ships hair. So I'm gonna attach her Instagram below and also her Booksy link and her contact, all that information, because that's my girl and we help one another out. Okay guys, I am done. My final look turned out amazing. I decided to rock blue for the evening instead of red. Here I am with my boo. We had a great night. Thanks for watching, guys.